Amen. The book of Matthew chapter 9 and verse 9. And read you these verses. And as Jesus passed forth from thence, he saw a man named Matthew sitting at the receipt of custom. And he saith unto him, follow me. And he arose and followed him. And it came to pass, as Jesus sat at meat in the house, behold, many publicans and sinners came and sat down with him and his disciples. And when the Pharisees saw it, they said unto his disciples, why eateth your master with publicans and sinners? But when Jesus heard that, he said unto them, they that be whole need not a physician, but they that are sick.
Amen.
But go ye and learn what that meaneth. I will have mercy and not sacrifice, for I am not come to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance.
Yes.
And my, what a wonderful message that the Lord preached there. Amen.
Amen.
Gives us such a glimpse of what Jesus, what his mission really was all about. What his ministry was.
Yes.
Amen. When we think about him stopping and looking down at Matthew, many times when you just read the Bible, sometimes you just miss so much when you can just read it and be reading it. He just didn't call a man named Matthew, amen, to come and follow after him. But he called Matthew.
Yes.
Alright? He didn't just call Matthew, he called Matthew.
Yeah.
Alright? That's, Matthew was not like your most glorious and most wonderful citizen of the city. Not everybody, well, matter of fact, very few people liked Matthew. You know? I mean, Matthew, it says there, he was at the city at the receipt of custom. He was a tax collector. He was a tax collector, and while maybe we think about paying our taxes, and a lot of times, you know, this time of year, and we think, man, I love this time of year, I get a tax return. I get a tax return, I just want you to know, the reason why you got a return is because you paid too much, and they took too much of your money for the rest of the year. They're just giving you a little bit of it back to make you feel good about it. Yeah. Oh, well. Amen. But won't get off on that. We'll save that for April 15th. But anyway, he was a tax collector. And at that time, a tax collector worked for the Roman government. Yes. He was a Jew, but he worked for the Roman government.
Yeah.
He was a traitor.
Yeah.
Man, he was one that he took from the people of Israel. And he gave it to the evil Roman government.
Right.
Yeah. He took from the people of Israel, and guess what? He was even guilty of taking more than his share.
Uh-huh.
He would take advantage of his own people. And then he could pocket some of it and send a little bit on the rest of it on the roll. And he would, that's why people didn't like him very much. He would take from people, and he would take from his own people, and he was destroying them, and he was helping the enemy.
Yes.
So when Jesus said, came and called Matthew, they said, can you believe he called Matthew?
Yeah.
Right.
Can you believe he called Matthew?
Right.
Matthew, the one that nobody likes.
Right.
The one that everybody despises. Amen. That's the one that Jesus called.
Yeah.
It wasn't Matthew.
Right.
It was Matthew. Right. I mean, man, nobody liked him. And everybody, you know, they despised this guy. And this is the one that Jesus stopped by and said unto him, follow me.
Yes.
Follow me. Leave that and come and follow me. Hallelujah. Yeah. Then, to make matters worse, he goes to Matthew's house to eat. Can you believe he's eating at Matthew's house? He went to Matthew's house. Can you believe that guy? And then, I mean, to think that he would even go to his house, and then it tells us that all, behold, many publicans and sinners came and sat down with him. and his disciples. Can you believe he's eating with Matthew's friends?
Right.
All of Matthew's friends are there. My, can you believe that? Yes. And all the religious men of the day, they looked down and looked on him and said, can you believe he's at Matthew's house eating with Matthew's friends? What kind of a man is that?
Right.
Why does your master eat with publicans and sinners?
Yes.
Amen. I love the response.
Right.
Man, the response is so classic when Jesus says that they that behold need not a physician, but they that are sick. And Jesus came to seek and to save that which was lost. Amen. Jesus, amen, came, amen, not that he might help those that are well, but he came to help those that are sick. Hallelujah. Amen. You know why a doctor don't make very many calls to the gym? Amen. He goes to the hospital. He goes to the hospital, right? He don't go. He goes to where the sick people are at. Jesus was one. Amen. That he was the great physician.
Amen.
The great physician. Have you ever had a bad doctor? I had to go see a cardiologist one time. And this guy's an educated man. He's been to a lot more college than I have. He's a smart man. When I was sitting there, and he asked me, hey, what do you do for a living? I pastor a church. Okay, check the word. And he goes down the list, asking me the questions about my life. And then, he does his examination. And then when he's done, he sits there and talks to me for a while. But the thing that stood out to me was this man that was a doctor, an educated man, a man that was intelligent. Okay, a man that knew about the heart, but man, he had the most filthy mouth.
Yeah.
He was a professional, supposed to be a professional. And I heard language in that doctor's office that I had never heard.
Wow.
Well, in a long time, all right? Amen. Thank you, Lord. Amen, I'm not around that stuff. I'm not around that. And it was like, you've got to be kidding me. You've got to be kidding me. Amen, that had something, the good cabinets about them, that had a pure background, a little bit, okay? The Bible says over and over again that Jesus was moved with compassion. That makes a great position.
Yes, it does.
Somebody that's compassionate.
Amen.
You know, when you're a doctor that feels your pain, a physician that knows your hurt. Amen. A doctor and a physician. Amen. That is aware. Amen. Of how you feel and of what you're feeling inside. Amen. That is a great physician. Amen. Not one that feels that cannot feel. Amen. The hurt of your life today. Amen. But Jesus is the great physician, and He knows the pain of your life. He knows how you're hurting. Amen. He knows what it is. Hallelujah. And He's concerned about your needs. They're bleeding. We want you to go see Dr. Goldeisen. And if they come and they're, and you know what? They look like they're contagious. All right? I want you to go see Dr. Jabin. Amen. If they come in and they say, you know, I want you to move. I just want to see the ones that are healthy. All right? I just want to see the one that's healthy. And they're just saying, Doctor, I'm just here for a checkup. I'm just here to get checked out. Okay, let me take a look here. You know, but you know what? But Jesus, He is aware of what we need. He is aware and He's concerned about your life. He's concerned about your life. It does not matter what you're going through. Amen. He's the great physician. And He's looking into your life. And He wants to care for you. Hallelujah. Amen. Here, if you look, amen, Jesus, amen, He heals Peter's mother-in-law in chapter 8. In Matthew chapter 8. He came to where Peter's mother-in-law was sick. He saw his wife's mother laid sick of a fever. And He touched her hand. Amen. He touched her hand. You know what? He came close to her.
Yes,
he did.
Right. Amen.
Man, does it bother you that when the doctor comes into the room, he washes his hands? And when he leaves, Jesus reached out to touch her. Amen. To touch her. Hallelujah. Amen. He was not afraid. Hallelujah. Amen. He is the great physician. Amen. And I'll tell you what, Jesus, this great physician, He has the perfect bedside manner. Yeah. He has the perfect bedside manner. Amen. He comes alongside. He's compassionate. He's caring. Amen. He touches. He heals. Amen. He knows. Man, today medicine is so specialized. You know that? Every medicine is so specialized. Man, you've got, you know, ear, nose, and throat. You've got, right? You've got the internist. All right? You've got, I'm drawing blanks here, okay? I want to make sure I said all the right doctors. You've got the foot doctor, the leg doctor, the head doctor. You've got all a doctor for everything. Everything in your life. I mean, it's specialized. We'll have to send you to this doctor. You go, well, we're going to have to send you to this doctor. And you can do a lot of running to different doctors before you get to the one that can take care of your problem. Amen. But Jesus is the great physician. Amen. The great physician. Amen. He can take care. Amen. You got your emergency room doctor. You got your intensive care room doctor. Right? You got your general floor doctor. You know what? You've got everything. You've got all different types of doctors. I'm glad that my God, amen, praise God, He is the great physician. The great physician. Hallelujah. Amen. If you go into the emergency, amen, emergency room, why do you go there? Because it's an emergency. Something happened I wasn't expecting. Something happened and now it's critical. Amen. It's bad. Let me tell you what, He's the great physician. Amen. He can handle the emergency. Amen. He can take care of the thing that happens right now. The unexpected thing. Amen. waiting for that final moment. Life support. Amen. Just that it's the very end. Well, let me tell you what, he is the great physician. Because when you feel like your world is coming to an end, when you feel like something in your life has come to an end, amen, and you're just waiting for the death sentence to come, amen, you're waiting for the bell to strike, amen, let me tell you what, he's the great physician. Amen, he can work even in the last moment. Amen, to turn it around. Amen, to bring healing. Hallelujah. He is the great physician. He's the great physician. He knows what it is you're doing. How many of you, come on, have got on the internet and went to WebMD? I'm going to be honest. Okay, I had a pain in my neck, so I went on the WebMD to find out what's causing the pain in the neck. Okay? Top on the list. Cancer, heart problems, okay? Aneurysm in the neck. Man, I'm thinking, I'm dying! I'm dying! Man, probably what I needed was a new pillow! You know what I'm saying? How many of you have been there? You're getting in panic. Oh no! Oh no! Then you went up and said, I got cancer! I've got cancer! I'm dying of this disease! I'm dying of heart failure! They say only 1 in 10 million people have it, and I've got it because all my symptoms line up. Yeah. You are a terrible doctor, and WebMD's a bad doctor, all right? Amen, but I tell you what, I know the great physician, and I can tell you this, he never misdiagnoses. Amen, he knows what you need today. Hallelujah, he knows what you need. Hallelujah. Like going to the doctor? Well, Mr. Brimm, you probably need to lose some weight. Drink more water. That's what they tell you. You know, $40. Lose weight, drink more water. Lose weight, drink more water. That's the, over and over again. That's you know, and I really think if I weighed 100 pounds, then you know, I say, careful, you're putting on a couple pounds. Right. Drink more water. How much water do you drink? I don't know. Drink it today. You don't know how much water. Drink more water. Man, they give you this prescription. Right? You know, we are living in the most medicated society. I mean, what is the world? People are, everybody's on medication. Man, it's all medication. You know, you go to that, well, let me write you a prescription for that. Let me write you a prescription for that. Our medicine cabinets are full. We are a medicated society. And there's treatments, all these treatments. Yes, and they charge an arm and a leg, right? To treat you. I thought maybe you guys would be shouting right now. I mean, seriously, they charge, and they wanted to run test after test after test. Tested, but we're not sure. That test was inconclusive. Do I get my $1,500 back? That test was inconclusive. So we need to run another test. We need to do this. I went one time for a kidney stone. He said, we'll take an x-ray. They took an x-ray, paid for the x-ray. He said, well, if we don't see nothing in the x-ray, we'll do a CAT scan. He says, if there's one there, they always show up in a CAT scan. Why didn't we do it first? Why did we not do it first thing? If they always show up in the CAT scan, why didn't we do that first? You know, it's just always one thing after another. Amen. The treatment sometimes is worse than the sickness.
Amen.
It is. The treatment sometimes is more painful. I'm glad that we got a great physician.
Oh, praise God.
Hallelujah. He's come for those who are sick today.
Hallelujah.
He's come for those who are sick today to help those that are sick.
Oh, yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Yeah. To help the sick. Man, we've got a lot of sickness around here, haven't we? A lot of sickness going around. And if somebody walks up to you and says, I'm sick, what do you do? Right? Yeah. Break out the Lysol, fog the room. Right? Put on gloves, right?
Right.
You know, that sickness go around since we're wearing gloves at church, you know? I don't want to catch that sickness. She never washed the gloves, so I don't know what the difference was. You know, I mean, what's the purpose? If you don't wash the gloves, you're still getting all the germ. Anyway, that was funny, you know? See that with the realization on her face when she dawned on her. That's true, I didn't wash the gloves. You know, here's the problem. You know, we are so scared of the sick.
Right.
He is not scared of the sick.
Right.
He is not scared. He's a great physician.
Right.
Amen. He's not worried about your sickness today.
Right.
Amen. While others may turn away. Amen. Jesus. Amen. Even if it was a leper. Amen. He would reach out to heal them. He did not care about the sickness. Amen. He came for the sick.
Right.
He came for the sick. Tell you what, we live in a sick society.
Yes.
You know what I know about when we hear things on news, and that's sick. We hear it all. We hear the tragedy and the violence and the wickedness and all that sin that's out there. We say, that's sick. But I want you to know, amen, He came to heal the sick. He came for our sick world. Amen. To be the Savior for the sick. Children to come. Allow them to come. way, even the children were comfortable around this great physician. Even the sick would seek him out and go in search of him.
Step out.